In this short video lecture, we want to give a quick overview of the underlying motivations for why we have strings in the first place. Okay, let's get started. So we've already seen that Java provides only 8 fundamental data types, one of which is a char. A char is a 2-byte data type which can store one single Unicode character. That character can be represented as one single character within single quotes, as shown here, or perhaps the equivalent numerical Unicode value for any such character. Here we see that the Unicode value for the euro symbol is hex 20AC or decimal 8364. All of this is fine and dandy for single individual characters. However, I think we can all easily agree that just about any realistic program will have some need for handling sequences of such characters, or in other words, text. Furthermore, we can probably also envision the need for routine manipulations of such text sequences. For example, think back to your earlier Hello World program. Can you imagine trying to print out a simple message using a clumsy, lengthy concatenation of individual characters such as this? I think we'd scare off most new computer science students if they had to do things this way. These, then, are some of the motivations for a new text-based or string class in Java. Fortunately for us, Java does provide for a dedicated string class. A string is simply any amount of text enclosed within double quotes, as we see here. Contrast that with an individual char, which is one character enclosed within single quotes. For example, this X is a string because it's inside double quotes, but this X is a char because it's within single quotes. There is a big difference between these in Java. Java provides the string class, and that's string with a capital S, as a predefined part of the Java API. The string API describes its various constructor forms and everything you can do to a string object using its available methods. The string class is automatically available to any Java program as part of the java.lang package, which we'll discuss soon. So we get this for free without having to do anything special. But it is important that you recognize that string is a Java class and not one of the 8 core data types. However, from the perspective of the programs we'll be writing, string has the appearance of being just another native data type for text variables and literals, as we see here. Here's how we could set up a string object called firstName, whose value is Joe, and here's how we could print out some simple greeting by concatenating together a string literal with a string object with another string literal. Okay, this is the quick and dirty introduction to strings. Let's take a look at some more of the details.